Well, welcome to the Laura Cross Country and Biathlon Centre. It's there somewhere. It's one of the busier days of competition at the 2014 Paralympic Winter Games. We have our fingers crossed that the weather will do the right thing by us. It looks a bit gloomy at the moment. There's been some rain around. It won't dampen the spirit of the competitors or the enthusiasm of the spectators. As the jury members, as you can see, are gathering to discuss the situation, leaving the decision as late as possible. But as we join you now, the situation does not look particularly rosy. Anyway, there's a busy schedule, as I mentioned. The 10K for the women, 12.5K for the men. Sitting categories are first up, followed by standing and then visually impaired. So a busy schedule, and we do want it to get underway on time. And we will stand by and see if that's possible. Out on the course, they're doing their best to make racing conditions as good as can be. Probably aware we've had warm conditions and snow has suffered accordingly. And it's still certainly good enough for racing, and that's what we hope we will have. The wind is there a little. The mascots are waiting in some anticipation. The snow's wet. 3 degrees, it's a little cooler than it has been. A very high humidity with the cloud around. And there's a bit more wind than there has been. 8 kilometres an hour. So yes, the women's 10K sitting event is first. And we have the winner of the 6K with us, Andrea Eskow. She was a did not finish in the cross country event with an asthma attack, so we hope she's all right. Here's the field. Oksana Masters of the United States will lead us away. And Andrea Eskow is slotted to start in bib 108 for Germany. Might well be favourite as long as she's fit. World media gathered. But goodness me, it's not so good in terms of the weather. I hope for a start. Men's 12.5K, there's your field again with Perez of the United States. We're leading them away and the interval starts. Field of 19. And Petushkov, who's already won 2 gold medals, will be the favourite. So they're the first two events, the women's 10K, men's 12.5K, sitting.
A neutralization zone, and then we take the time and we will let them go. Okay?
Over here of whether there's going to be any delay to the start. We certainly hope not. Ludmila Pavlenko is in the field also, who won the 12K cross country. There's Eskow. Certainly hope she's fit. But the visibility at the range is the issue. And the athletes probably ski safely enough around the course, but it's whether the visibility is good enough for them at the range, even allowing for the fact it's only a 10 meter distance between athlete and target. Visibility is quite poor. I think that you say, as you can see, but as you can only partly see, but we're going to get things underway and hope that conditions are lightened and improved. This is good. Up to the start comes Oksana Masters. So we're going to get a start in the women's 10K sitting biathlon. And Oksana Masters was fourth in the 6K biathlon and a silver medalist in the cross-country 12K. And off into the mist she goes. This is a tough job, tough day for our crew here at Lowra, trying to pick up the athletes and bring you the best pictures that they possibly can. And Oksana Masters is on her way, followed by Lidzia Rafaeva. She had a ninth place finish in the 6 kilometer biathlon. Participating in the first of the cross-country events at 12K at Rafaeva from Belarus on the way. And next to go is Oksana Abdikarimova, a 29-year-old from Moscow. 10th in the 6K biathlon. And she's only been competing for a few years. She's there somewhere. Oh my goodness, this is, I wonder if it's getting worse. I hope not. But I think they've started with the expectation, or at least the hope, that conditions will get better. Anja Vicker, great competitor. The 22-year-old German from Stuttgart. 6th in the 6K biathlon. 8th in the 12K cross country. Got a terrific attitude and really enjoys competition, and she's fun to watch because she finds it fun. That's what, to a degree, it's about. We're reminded of that at the opening ceremony. Go out there, compete hard, and have fun. Ludmila Pavlenko of Ukraine from Kharkiv. The winner of the 2005 World Championship in the 10K biathlon. So she's had success at the very top level in this event, and also in cross country here. She's already a gold medalist in the 12K, so this distance will not be a problem for Ludmila Pavlenko. Marta Zanulina from Kazan, the Russian Federation. Zanulina had a fifth place, not far off the medals in the 6K as Masters. The visibility out on that little bit of the course, maybe a touch better. Yakovska now. Had a podium finish in the 6K in the biathlon. Third place for her. Rafaeva coming through the 1.1 kilometer checkpoint, outside the time of Oksana Masters. Do not adjust your sets, I'm afraid this is how it is. It's misty. What we don't want is rain on this already wet snow. 108 is Andrea Eskow. Well, she's had a real mixed bag, has Eskow. A gold medal in the 6K biathlon and an asthma attack in the middle of the cross country. She had to withdraw. And it's most unexpected. She's not a regular... asthma doesn't come away often, is what I was saying. It's an asthma sufferer. It's not quite the right term, but I have to deal with asthma often. Maria Yovleva is off from the Komi Republic in northwest Russia. Abdikarimova chasing Oksana Masters around the course, but not as quick as the American. And, the fact of time will help her a little. Svetlana Konovalova. Konovalova was second in the biathlon 6K and third in the cross country. So the field is away. 10 in it. Here's Vicker, 15 seconds behind Masters. I'm a little puzzled the way they've seeded this, because Masters, her form coming into these Paralympic Winter Games was good. They've got her going away first. although she should be one of the slower athletes, but she's not. Pavlenko, 15 seconds slower than Oksana Masters. Masters really should be going in the last three or four. However, I don't think she'll mind going out first. Sometimes you can get the best of the conditions if you are out early. Zainulina going through in 106. A bit of testing going on at the range to see what the visibility is like. And in comes Oksana Masters. They handed the rifle. Four visits to the range in this one. There are five loops of 2 kilometres. Getting some trouble. This is it. She's got the hand frozen to the stop. Well, that's a real waste of time there for Masters, and it's most unfortunate. Couldn't get the stock out of the glove. Anyway, Masters is ready now. I hope she can see better than we can. Well, that's good result there. Well, that's not. The favour is into the range. And you see that the time lost by Masters, the favour has put down all five of her targets, and Masters has got a couple of penalty loops to do after those two misses. So after a very quick first lap, things have gone awry for Masters. So she's got a couple of penalty loops to do. Russian team checking their watches. They'll be looking for Abdikarimova to come in, and here she is. Oksana Abdikarimova through the gloom across to her shooting position in just a moment. Rafaeva of Belarus shot clear. Say about the sporting philosophy, and she'll tell you what she feels about competing as a Paralympic athlete. It's not just to come, race, win and leave. People in our country, and she's referring to the Russian Federation, must change their general attitude towards those with impairments. They see us on track, see what we do and what athletes from other teams do. All this can help change their attitude. Wow. Doesn't need to change anything about the way she shoots. No penalties there for Abdikarimova. Zainulina. 3 from 3. This is very encouraging that they're able to shoot accurately in these conditions. It seems the jury has made the right choice in allowing the race to commence. There's a bit of wet snow and rain coming down. Quite difficult conditions. Rakowska is in. Time at the bottom of the screen there, Zainulina is the quickest leaving the range after the first time. A miss there. Two misses for Rakowska. Oh, that's unfortunate. So that's 300 metres extra. She's got to ski. A couple of penalty loops for her. Here's Eskow, one of the race favourites. This is her style, likes to start with the middle target, then go left. And very sure of them all. Good, steady shooting from Andrea Eskow. That's what we saw from her in the 6K. But this time, instead of twice, they've got to do it four times. And somewhere there is Yovlova, the Russian Maria Yovlova. I can't see her as well as she can see the targets. Goal one this. 4 out of 5 for Yovlova. She's only 24. Konovalova, also only 24. Biathletes, cross-country competitors tend to be at their peak late 20s, even early 30s, and beyond. Konovalova. Very quickly through her work, and Eskow's time of 6:27.3. She won't beat that, but she'll be close enough to challenge. And Konovalova out and on her way to the second lap, 12 seconds behind Eskow. Masters. It's a semi-disastrous stop at the range. Not only did she have two misses, but she could not get the glove off the stop. And I could only think it was frozen on her. So she's a minute 47 down on Rafaeva. They are the same sport class, so that's real time that she's down there. Jainulina is going past another athlete there and coming up towards a 3.1 kilometre checkpoint. And it's tough for the competitors, but do spare a thought for our hard-working crew who are peering through the gloom and getting wet and bringing you the best pictures we can. Abdikarimova, 30 seconds behind Jainulina. Wicker. Pretty close. Vika with a 90% factoring applied to her time. She's a W10.5 sport class. Pavlenko, the gold medalist from the 12K cross country, as members standing around wondering what's going to happen here. Keep our fingers crossed that the weather doesn't deteriorate further so that we can get through what is a busy schedule today. Rafaeva coming down for her second shoot. Rafaeva got through her first without penalty. Eskow, certainly one of the more efficient and quicker skiers in this race. And she's got 18 seconds under the time of Zanulina. For the sake of Eskow and for the sake of the race, that she doesn't have another dose of the asthma that took her out of the cross country the other day. Yerkseva, 1:24 down on Eskow, so Eskow looks to be back to her best. Konovalova in the 110 bib and the 10th to go out, 10th and final athlete. She's also outside the time of Eskow by 17 seconds. Now that's not so very much. Should you be joining us for your first look at Paralympic Winter Games Biathlon? The athletes don't ski around the course with the rifle on their back as they do in Olympic or able-bodied competition. The rifle is held and prepared for them. The skis have to stay on. And it's not easy getting into a comfortable position to shoot with the six ski still attached, but this is how it's done. The Masters. Two penalties on the first shoot. The only other athlete who had two was Yerkovska. And that explains the slow times for both. We've got to time the breathing between shots. Another pellet into the chamber while they're breathing. Just air rifles, not 22 caliber, as they are in other competitions. And she's had another two misses. This is really unfortunate for Oksana Masters. Zainulina, meanwhile, shot clean the first time and the second. So that's 10 out of 10 for Marta Zainulina, who was fifth in the 6K, but just off the podium. What about today? She might be able to make up for that. Now, Vika, 5 out of 5 the first time. Steady as she goes here for Vika, and again. She's competing very well. Pavlenko. One of the older competitors in the field, although Eskow at 42 is the veteran, but at 32, Pavlenko. Long time over that last shot, but it was worth it. I always say a couple of seconds extra over a sure shot is a good investment, rather than to find yourself doing a penalty loop, which will take you 25 to 30 seconds, depending on your impairment. Eskow. Oh, first miss of the day. And she doesn't miss often. 9 out of 10. Now that puts a few other people back into the race, with Eskow incurring her first miss. In comes Konovalova. Shot clear the first time. Notice too that the athletes are allowed to keep the stocks with them while they shoot, and this enables them to get back to the upright position. Yavleva. Oh, and a miss for Yavleva. So she's had one at each of the first two shooting bouts, and there are four today in this longer race, the middle distance race they call it. Konovalova is out now in the lead position. Eskow with that miss, brought back to the field. Positions now, Konovalova and then Wicker, then Zainulina. Eskow has dropped from first to fourth. Kukowska back in seventh position. She's had a bad day with the rifle so far, with a total of three misses. Zainulina. For her time through the 5.1 kilometer checkpoint. And Konovalova has had a third in the cross country, a second in the 6K biathlon. She could get the complete set within three races, Konovalova, if she were to win this one. Okay, we're watching Zainulina there, disappearing into the mist. And the athletes are moving along quite quickly, do well not to take a wrong turn. They know the course well. It's 5 2-kilometer laps. No Japanese competitors in this field, but they're sprinkled throughout other events. Anya Vicker coming around to the 5.1 kilometer checkpoint. Inside Zainulina's time, but the one we've got to keep an eye on next is Konovalova. The favour now is 3:37 down. She's just having a bad day at the office. masters with four misses and the most unusual delay for her at the first shoot. And she couldn't get the stock away from the glove. Abdekarimova, 55 seconds outside of this time. All right, here we go. This is the crucial checkpoint. It's Konovalova coming up to 5.1 k's. Let's see how close she is to Vika if she's inside that time. It's going to be close. Yep, 15 seconds. So Konovalova back into first position. There she was when she left the range, so continuing to ski well. And Yukovska, unfortunately, with the number of misses she's had, three in all, she's well down. She'll need some others to miss on the next two shoots to have a chance. Eskow, 26 seconds outside Konovalova. Now, Eskow, on her day, is a quick enough skier to make up for the miss that she's had, but she's further behind than I expected. So I think out on the course, Eskow might be slowing down as well. Yavlova, 127 behind Konovalova. So the rankings at the moment, Konovalova, Vika, and Zainulina. So Russia, Germany, and Russia. One. So the Germans splitting the two Russians. Zainulina was a little agitated that the rifle was a bit slow in coming. She was there, ready to accept it. So a couple of seconds given up there to poor teamwork. And she misses the first. Zainulina. And the second miss. So she was sitting third. She won't be shortly. Of course, if the athlete's fatigue, the shooting can go off. It requires great self-control, great skill and technique, and mastering of the breathing. As they get more fatigued, the challenge of shooting accurately grows. So they're coming into the range thick and fast now. Masters. Four penalties so far. She badly needs a clean shoot here to have any kind of a chance of a podium finish. And she's not got the rifle zeroed correctly. Just what's going on. Oh, missed. Masters. Meanwhile, Vika is shot clear again. And Anya Vika is having a wonderful competition. This is her third event, Anya Vika, the German. Leave her troubles for the moment and see Vika leaving the range quite confidently, skiing well, pushing along towards what could be a medal. Konovalova has missed one. All right, she's trying to make it interesting too. That's her first miss, so back to the field she'll come. Might leave Vika in the lead. Karimova, good job. So she's 15 out of 15 at the range. My goodness, that'll lift you up the rankings. While others are missing around you, if you can keep your head. Now, Eskow. This is a crucial five shots coming up right now for the outcome of this race. Oh, miss. And a second. Oh. Well, that's... Eskow, I think she's pulling out. I think Eskow's just withdrawn. Well, okay, and Yavlova has got a problem with the clip. Jammed there. And Eskow, yes indeed, she's out. She's had a couple of misses, perhaps a breathing. She's having trouble with it again. We know she's had an asthma attack the other day. Yovlova, meanwhile. A couple of misses there. And Yovlova's in trouble. Well, the second time that Eskow, our gold medalist from the 6K event, has withdrawn. That's very sad news for Andrei Eskow, such a dogged competitor. A gold medalist in the London Paralympics in paracycling, hand cycling. Lefeva out on the course, looking for a time through that 7.1 kilometer checkpoint. This race is going to be a survival of the fittest and the most accurate. The range is where it's all happening. Change is coming over the position very quickly. Shrug of the shoulders from the German team. Well, I don't know what the reason is, because she's not seeking medical attention. Meanwhile, Germany still had good chances here with Anja Vicker. It would be quite a story if Anja Vicker were to parlay this into some kind of podium finish. She's only 22. First visit to the Paralympic Games. But a second at the World Championships in the 6K last year. And this would be some kind of achievement for her at Paralympic level. But that's some way off. Let's not get ahead of ourselves. Yakovska is out there whittling away at the lead. Vicker, Yakovska, her third shoot, she went clear. So two penalties, then one, then none. So Yakovska is gathering some momentum, and Konovalova is only 14 seconds behind Vicker. It's repeating the news that one of the race favourites, Andrea Eskow, has withdrawn. Karimova continuing to get around the course pretty efficiently. Pavlenko, a minute 40 down. Let's look at Pavlenko's. She had two penalties at the third shoot. It's dropped her down the standings.
Great. You did well. I'm happy with you.
Masters, who's now missed seven targets in all, two at the first, two at the second, and three at the third shoot. So that's counted her out. Raised the question at the start why she wasn't seated higher in the field and starting later. She's given us an answer of sorts, but it's also what needs to be said is that she finished fourth in the 6K. So the fourth and final visit to the range is coming up. Zanulina. Big pun, a favour. Miss for the third. Fourth is good. Four out of five. Favour's got a penalty loop to do. 109 is Yovlova. Now that asterisk next to her name may mean she's going to have some trouble with the officials. I'm not sure. I don't have that on my screen here. But it's on the monitors. But, there's some issue around Yovlova. He should be disqualified. I hope that's not the case, but there's usually a reason for that mark next to the name. Now Vicker, she's going to get a podium finish here. She needs five more accurate shots. Vicker, four out of four. Come on, one more. Brilliant. 20 out of 20. That's going to serve you so well in the biathlon. She's certainly got this half of the event down pat. And Vicker's on her way. She's well inside Rafaeva's time, of course, but she'll have plenty to worry about with Konovalova. So Vicker for the moment. And Konovalova has missed one. Well, this is really interesting now. Konovalova quicker around the course, but has missed a shot crucially. And Vicker has got a ski, the fastest 2K she can muster, and she's got a shot at first place. Pavlenko. She could manage 5 out of 5 here, Pavlenko. She could challenge Yakovska. Yakovska the quicker skier. Pavlenko with a more generous factor on her time. She's LW11 sports class, 94% factoring applied to her time. And so Pavlenko heads out onto the course again. Pavlenko Abdikarimova, 5 out of 5, and Abdikarimova, just as Vicker has done, a clean shoot at all four stops. She's having a little trouble with that right-hander, but now she's got herself set, and away she goes. 151 behind Vicker. Konovalova. Get you a split on Konovalova against Vicker. She's about 50 seconds behind Vicker when she left the range. Now that might be too much for her to make up. 48.9 is the exact split. And Yoglova. Wait for clarification about what that asterisk next to her name means, but I don't think it can be good news. She's had a miss with her last shot, so Yoglova misses at all four stops and a total of 5 penalties for her. 750 meters extra you've got to ski when you add up all those penalty laps. Rafaeva out on the course with just about 900 meters to go in this 10K middle distance sitting event for the biathlete, 6 gears. And Vicker. He's got to keep upright and keep pushing on. And the Paralympic title just might be hers. Mentioned at the start of the event, I just like watching her compete. She's just got this sort of sunny attitude to the whole thing. Gives her the best, smile never far from her lips, and she's had a 6th place in the 6K biathlon, 8th in the 12K cross country, but because she shot well and skied right up to her potential, the top of the podium finish was within range for Vicker. Konovalova coming through 9.1 Ks, and she's taken. Then Yakovska, Abdikarimova, Zanulina, Yavlova, Rafaeva, and Oksana Masters in 9th spot. And as mentioned, Andrei Eskow unable to complete the event. Thank you. happy, the Glamour team. Anja Vicka took up skiing in 2006. Sporting philosophy is no risk, no fun. She has plenty of fun out there. Imagine what a great disposition she seems to have. And just turned 22. Start time for the next race, the men's 12 and a half pace sitting, about 3 minutes. So unless there's we think about visibility, it doesn't look like it's got worse for me, but I feel we should get a start. Caught outside, isn't it? You don't know what you're going to get. You just got a proper sweep. One there is Enzo Mazziello, Italy. All sorts of worried faces, talking into two-way radios, mobile phones. How's it look up there? Well, not too bad, not too good. What about where you are? All the same. I'm not sure able to give us a start. It's our friend Kozo Kubo. Again, one of these guys who just loves competition, loves being here. Yeah, I can still do that stretch. That's the men's 12.5k, 5 loops of 2.5 kilometres, punctuated by 4 visits to the range. And here's the field. Augusto Jose Perez to lead them away. Four Americans there, Jeremy Wagner and Sean Halstead, Martin Flag, Germany. Field of 19, Roman Petushkov looking for what would be a third victory in as many races. He's challenged by the likes of Yorovji, Bychenok, Kubo, Goncharov. We've got competitors from the United States, Russia, Poland, Ukraine, Norway. I think Kristina Larsson is there. Face painting, ever popular around the world of spectator sport. We don't give camera operators much thought in days like this, but let me tell you, they really struggle to keep their equipment dry and functional. It's a big concern for them when there's rain around. Looks like we're going to get a punctual start, so that's fantastic. Augusto Jose Perez, originally from Madrid. And Perez gets us underway in the men's 12.5k sitting biathlon in misty, cloudy, rainy conditions at Laura. And that's far from the mind of Perez as he sets off. The 41-year-old appearing at his third Paralympic Winter Games. His name, the Goose. Vladimir Gajica from Slovakia. He's been competing a good while. He was in Salt Lake, Torino, Vancouver. This is his fourth. Got a silver medal in cross country back in Salt Lake. That's his highest placing at a Paralympic Winter Games. Rosiek at his third game, the 29-year-old Polish competitor. Rosiek 13th in the 7.5K biathlon and 11th in the cross country. Whoops, whoops, whoops. Oh dear, down goes Perez. Took that turn a bit fast. Some time there, back around onto the course as he should do. Everything in order again. Alexander Kornikko of Ukraine. Competed last year's World Championships in Sweden in both cross country and biathlon. Jeremy Wagner of the United States. He's born in Honolulu and lives in Denver, Colorado. Not a lot of snow in Hawaii, a bit more in Denver. He's 52 years of age, Jeremy Wagner. He's only been in the sport for a couple of years, so he's done very well to qualify for Paralympics. Sean Halstead, 43-year-old from Spokane, Washington. Three top tens in Vancouver, Sean Halstead. He's actually disqualified in the 7.5K biathlon, 9th in the cross country. This is a 15K event. One of many athletes doubling up across both disciplines. Love competition. Another man from Flisa in Norway. Kristina Larsen. Seventh in this event 4 years ago in Vancouver. The bronze medal in Vancouver in the relay cross country. 19 in this field. Larsen heads off. Next is Martin Flagg. He's 24 years of age from Gundel Kingman. My pronunciation is close, at least. The championships, he's been competing in those since 2009. Check out, he's been a busy athlete so far, Petushkov, with a 10th in the cross-country 15K and a 12th in the biathlon 7.5K. 57-year-old, he's from Kaki. Dmitry Loban of Belarus. Next to go. In cross country, he had a bronze medal in Vancouver in the 10K. Biathlon World Championships last year, three top 10 finishes. Enzo Macchiello. Vancouver, he was the flag bearer for Italy at the closing ceremony. Out on the course, we're looking at the 1.6K checkpoint, and through goes Camilo Rosiek. Ivan Goncharov. Gets a big hand from the locals, of course, as he'd hope, as you'd expect. the 8-year-old from Moscow. Had a 19th in the 15K cross country event in Vancouver. And the team successful at World Championship. Daniel Nelson. Next to go, the 33-year-old American. This one comes to pick up. Ragnar setting a new best mark to the 1.6K. American Andrew Sol. Should keep an eye on Andrew. He's had two top five finishes so far. Fourth in the 7.5K biathlon. Fifth in the 15K cross country. So he's very close to getting himself on the podium, Andrew. In Vancouver, and he's the first US biathlete to win a Paralympic medal. In cross country, that is. And that was in the biathlon pursuit. This time, biathlon. Jorovyi. Second in the 7.5K. So he's already picked up a silver medal. Fourth in the cross country. Jorovyi in good form, and there are only four to go in the field. And they are from Russia and Japan only. Three Russians to come. Bychenok checks his own watch. And Alexey, another Muscovite, sets off. 37 years of age. And 2004. Began training in Paralympic sports, tennis, wheelchair racing. Murygin from Omsk. Still a very young competitor, just turned 19. Seen in the earlier biathlon event, the shorter one, so if he likes the longer distances, well, he's been saved for this one. Low band just outside Halstead's time at the early checkpoint, 1.6K. Here's our friend Kozo Kubo, Japan. 52-year-old out of Abashiri. World Championship bronze medals last year. And a bronze medal here in the 7.5K biathlon. And now, Roman Petushkov. Got to be the hot favourite here. He's won both events he's gone in so far. Gold in the 7.5K biathlon. Gold in the cross-country 15K. Marciello, meanwhile, getting it done out on the course. So everyone's away. About 10 minutes to get them away with 19 competitors, 30 seconds between each. So Halstead, into the range we are. Let's see how he goes. Got to keep a clean sheet as far as the visits to the range are concerned. And that is a platform in which you can really launch yourself into the event. That's got a good result. Halstead, 3 out of 3. Taking his time, but doing it effectively. So Halstead, 5 out of 5. Well, he's a shot clean. Wagner, Fornico, and Rosiek. Single misses for Perez and Galgitia, Slovakia, and Halstead. Magna, doing it nicely for the United States. But plenty of quick athletes behind them. Flag, few breaths and then another shot. And one breath. Well done. So as he gets more and more oxygen into the lungs, he can reduce the number of breaths between shots. And that method is worth the treat to flag. He'll come out, I think, a little ahead of Halstead's time. And after the first shoot, flag is your new leader. Yorovyi. Doing a good job. She's closing in on Andrew Sol. Loban. Well done. I think we'll get to the checkpoint exit mark quicker than flag 7:24, but Loban is 5 out of 5. Lee's got a feeling of confidence about the race. Much as anything, that's what 5 out of 5 would be for the first time around. Okay, I'm on my game. I'm a chance here. And just 10 seconds down. Enzo Masiello, 4 out of 5. Please report no one has missed more than one. And visibility, certainly no worse than when the race started, and perhaps a shade better. One shot of 5 out of 5. And the crowd like that. The Russian puts himself into contention. He could be the new leader. Taking about another 20 seconds to get to flag's time. And to the exit point, it'll be a close thing, but anyway, he's got to pass 14 seconds off it. And Nossen, he's had a miss. Just to be patient. If you do have that early miss and you know the others haven't, tell yourself it's a long race, I can still get back into this. Take it bit by bit. And you saw a little ponytail picking out from behind the head there under the beanie. And left hand has got it done. Well done. We'll be close to Gonchirov's time. I would have come into this race thinking, look, I'm close to a medal here. As he just tightens the strap around the glove. Alexey Bychenok. Out of five for Bychenok. He'll have the new quickest time. I think he's got to come inside the Gonchar at 7:10 quite easily. Just at that pace. And 13 seconds for the good. And two more Russians still in there. Now Murygin has a miss against his man. Looking for Kubo and Petushkov. Two drops of rain on the lenses of our cameras. There's Petushkov. If he's quick enough, he'll be good enough. If he's straight enough. That's quite fast shooting from Petushkov indeed. So away he goes. And Petushkov has come to these games in such great form. He's 2 out of 2 so far at his event. 2 gold medals, and Petushkov could leave town with a bag full. Just a few seconds down on Yorogi. Tozo Kubo of Japan will be the last to shoot. He's in the range now. Kubo, LW11. 94% factoring applied to his time. Meanwhile, the earlier athletes are out approaching the 4-kilometer checkpoint, 4.1 to be precise. See there, Dmitry Loban of Belarus. Just under Konica. 2 down. Enjoys a bit of weightlifting and swimming and arm wrestling. Sasha, 20, and he's at bay. Konica. Round that bend safely. And behind him, 52 is Gavitsia. Konica started a minute after him. Both in the LW12 fourth category. Didn't really see Kubo at the range, but I can report to you he had no misses. And he's about 44 seconds down on our leader, who is... A little at the moment is Goncharov. Some have shot second time and some haven't. But Wagner, he's 10 out of 10 now. Yorogi was the leader through the first shoot. And Kubo was 46 seconds down on him at that time. With Yorogi, then Petushkov, then Bychenok. Goncharov was fourth after the first shoot. Five. Just single breaths between shoots, between shots, and that's a very efficient visit to the range from Flag. It almost catches them by surprise. The right, first right-hand turn they have to make. And he should be able to come in under Halstead's time of 15.09. Quite comfortably by 16 seconds. Murygin. Checking he had one penalty at the first shoot. He's the youngest in the field, Murygin, just 19. This is Loban at 32. 10 out of 10. He lost what time he saved at the range with what would have been a time-wasting fall. Kept his balance though. Can be tricky. Suspension devices attached to these series, but yes, in the Alpine events, but not in the biathlon. He's picking a lot of the marches. There are six ski arrangements. There's all sorts of ways to construct them, depending on the impairment of the athlete. Goncharov, he's 10 out of 10. He'll come from the range under the time of flag of 14.54 almost. Goncharov. The longer they shoot clear, the longer they stay in contention. The crowd cheers that effort. Sol. big, strong man, Andrew Stoll. Can he be 10 out of 10? Yes, he can. He's really putting some pressure on to get this first medal of these games. Top five placings, as I mentioned, for Andrew, and the bronze medal in the 2.4k biathlon pursuit back in Vancouver. Bychenok, meanwhile, he's also 10 out of 10. Here we go, he's going to take something out of Goncharov's time. More than something. 20 odd seconds. 24. Bychenok on his way. And just three behind him, Murygin, Kubo, and Petushkov. Here's Murygin. Oh, the one miss. Oh, none the second time around. That's great marksmanship from the 19-year-old. Grigory Murygin. And he trains out of the Center of Olympic Training in Avant-Garde, Omsk. Petushkov. Absolutely the man to beat. He's rock steady. He's quick. And he's 10 out of 10. Unless something goes wrong with his day, we'll have his third gold medal from as many events. Petushkov into the lead by 14 seconds from Bychenok. Petushkov, then Bychenok, then Murygin. Larson is 6.6k, so he's just past the halfway point. Always record in Olympic cross-country and biathlon. Not more imposing than in Paralympic events. And at the moment, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 for Russia with some pressure coming from Andrew Sol, but he's got seconds to make up there, at 17 of them. Because of Kubo, who we didn't see at his first shoot, but as you can see, he shot clear, no penalty so far. We've been right in 10 out of 10. His first two visits. He is a bronze medalist in the 7.5k biathlon. Kubo comes out next position. He's off the pace today. Could be he's had his best race, but the impression I'm getting from his last two competitions is couldn't go with the pace in the cross country. He was 14th. Have a look at the race so far for Petushkov. German coaches watching the range intently. They've got Martin Flag to worry about in this event. Sol just sitting outside a podium position at the moment. If he keeps the clean sheet at the range, there might be a chance for a podium finish. Halstead, his American teammate, is there now. And Halstead's that's just had his first miss. And his second. Oh dear. Didn't need that. And Wagner. They went out to one after the other from the start gate. With a perfect record, there goes another in flight, so he's got his first penalty. Martin off for the penalty loop. Logan. Following the pack, starting in the middle and and then right, and it works all right, and he's 15 out of 15, well done. So keep that kind of shooting going and let the others fall apart around you, something good might come your way. Loban finds himself temporarily in the lead here as he comes past the third shoot checkpoint. Group of them together now. They start 30 seconds apart. It's a different pace and the different fortunes at the range unfold, and they can end up with quite a few skiers together. Bunch of and as poor as the visibility may look to you at home, not so bad when you get shooting like this from Goncharov. Kornikow hasn't missed. Loban hasn't missed. Wagner is 14 out of 15, and so is Flight. So the targets are close enough for the athletes to be untroubled by the mist and rain. Bychenok. That's in third place. Coming into the range. And he certainly won't drop with that kind of performance. He's 15 out of 15. This could be a very good day for Russia. They've already swept one event. Up 38 seconds inside Goncharov's time. Murygin had one miss at the first shoot, might have rocked his confidence, but he got it back in a hurry. 10 out of 10 since then. I'm wondering why he didn't compete in the shorter race, the 7.5K. Murygin just 5 seconds behind Bychenok. And Petushkov now. My goodness, he's a competitor. He just doesn't look like anything. He just oozes confidence. And out on the course, he just powers his way around. Just leans into the corner, helps himself get around. And it's here, inside Quinto Tank. A bit more about Petushkov. 4 gold medals at the 2013 World Championships in cross country. But until these games, he hadn't had a victory in a Paralympic Winter Games cross-country or biathlon event. He had a second in Vancouver in the 15K cross country, and a third in the biathlon 12.5K. So this event 4 years ago, the Petushkov was the bronze medalist. Yorogi. It's unfortunate. He had one in the second of the range two, and now he's missed two. He's pushed the body in that prone position. Not a comfortable way to have to shoot. Managing pole conditions is quite challenging at times for athletes with leg impairments. Athletes who have no feeling in their extremities, not aware of how cold they might be getting, and it's something that has to be carefully managed on their behalf and by the athletes themselves. Kubo. Oh, Mr. Efficient at the range, Kubo. There you go. That's wheelchair racing, marathon event. Put himself through the endurance aspect of the sport. There's a lay there for Kubo. ...94% factoring applied to his time. Back with Tornico. First miss. Oh, and two at the last. That can be the pattern, of course, where the athletes get more tired later in the race, that's when they're more likely to miss. And the fine motor skills of the marksmanship are required. The body can't wait to deliver what the brain requests. Mr. Jose Perez, our Spanish-born American, his way around the course, knocking 209 down on Bychenok's time. Knocking not really a big thing today. American was the 14th in the 7.5K. Petushkov, meanwhile, business as usual, out front. He's a great front runner. Starts well and just gets better. He's unbelievable. Loving competing on his home snow. Mikhailo Chechenko took the position nice and quickly. The rifle handed to him just when he wants it. Let's see what he can do here with his fourth shoot. Loban top right. Loban. He's got a shot clear until now. That's excellent. Loban has had 20 out of 20. Chenko now had his second miss. Now he's done with the range. Loban will draw and truly trim the time of Alexander Bychenko. About 2.5 minutes. Just one penalty so far. But Jeremy Wagner. Talking about it in his own sweet time, but knocking these targets over one by one, one after the other, and he doesn't miss there. So 19 out of 20. The completed total for Jeremy Wagner. Goncharov, he's gone clear. So Goncharov and Loban. Hugo is 15 out of 15, Petushkov likewise. Goncharov is our new leader. And he actually got the opportunity to shoot clear. Andrew Sol. Sol hasn't missed. Andy's not going around the course quickly enough, I think, to get himself under the podium of Russia. Doing so well here, it's still very much in play that Russia could get the 1-2-3. Petushkov. He knows he's got a lead. 5 out of 5 here, and the race must be his. Petushkov. He's done it. Of course he's done it. 20 out of 20. And the Russian voices ringing in his ears as they send him off for one last lap. Two and a half kilometres to ski. And it could be a third Paralympic title for him here at the Lauda Cross Country and Biathlon Centre. He's rapidly turning into one of the athletes of the game. Roman Petushkov. Mr. Jose Perez. A couple of counter misses here. That's a shake of the head. For a penalty loop, and he'll be stuck there for a bit. That's a shame. That'll slow his race down significantly and extend it. Asiello getting himself organised. Missed it for the first three stops. Anymore. But he's got one more, that's a shame. Only 3 out of 5 there, so he's got a bit more work to do. Just when you don't want it, the body's hurting, you get yourself off for the extra meters around the penalty loop. How it works here in biathlon, those with the self-control, with the body under stress, and the ones who emerge victorious. 57 here is Sigurd Steiner Larsen. Nicely balancing his way around that fairly tight left-hand downhill turn. Loban, 2.5 minutes inside that time of Rosiek, the Polish competitor. Some of these early starters beginning to think about the finish. A bit of breeze disturbing the flags, the range there. Not much though. If anything, the breeze is backed off a little. There's a Kubo. That's a piece of fourth shoot. Get to miss. How about that? He's 20 out of 20. Had a fifth and a seventh placing in Vancouver. When he picked up his third place in the 7.5K event, Kozakuba with his first Paralympic medal. So whatever happens from here on in, Kubo is going to regard these games in Russia as a highlight of his career. Out he goes for 2.5 more kilometres. It's a couple of minutes down on Petushkov. Certainly he's done all he can with his rifle. Now it's up to his shoulders. Send him around the course once more. He's really digging in. Anyway, down to the finish we come. We've got Rosiek of Poland, Kamil Rosiek. 29-year-old. Appearing at his third Paralympic Winter Games. That's the early time to beat, but 40 minutes 25. There'll be plenty coming under that. Rosiek, he's done his absolute best. Looking at how many targets he missed, 3 in all. Edicia, Slovakia, coming through almost a minute slower than Rosiek. Edicia also missing 3 penalties. Winnaker, he's only missed a couple, and up into second place he goes, 9 seconds behind Rosiek. Peering out of the gloom of the home straight, in comes Loban. Oh, he's really taken some time out of those earlier finishes, 2.5 minutes Loban, and no misses at the range. Well, we've had several do that today, but Loban, the first to finish. And again, that's wonderful sportsmanship we see in the finish area as they each congratulate the other for the race that they've had today. Chechenko of Ukraine coming in, and 2 misses for him. Flag in the second position for the moment. Flag, just the 1 miss. And Bychenok. Well, there is a seriously new time, 35.29. Bychenok also no misses. So the men sitting first and second at the moment, both 20 out of 20 with a rifle. Halstead, 4 minutes off the time of Bychenok. Goncharov into second position now. Goncharov also no misses. Very impressive in these difficult conditions to come away 5 out of 5, 4 times. Sol, not third at the moment, but he's not going to stay there. He too is shot clear. Unbelievable marksmanship from some of these guys today. Petushkov across the line. Well, he's caught us by surprise out of the mist. 41 seconds quicker than Bychenok, and he knows that that's probably going to be good enough. And now we've got Russia 1-2-3. Murygin. Now you've got Russia 1-2-3-4. Murygin slides into third place. They're coming across the line in a rush now. And we've quite quickly got 13 who finished. Make that 14 as Larson comes across. Larson with 4 penalties. This is for back home, I'm sure. This has been, this is going to be a field day for the Russian team. Petushkov, Bychenok, Murygin and Goncharov. 1-2-3-4. Most impressive about that, though, is that it's a third win for Petushkov from as many events. Down to the line is coming Dan Lenossen. Inside the time of his teammate John Halstead. Shoot as accurately as these fellows have done. Murygin actually missed two targets. The 19-year-old is still in third position and likely to stay there. And athletes after him have finished fourth and fifth and sixth, all shot clear. So Murygin, you take about 40 seconds perhaps off his time. And he would have maybe had second place, not first, but just anyway. Yes, one, two, three, four. Only three will be on the podium, but we get the point. It's Russia. One, two, three, and four. Petushkov, Bychenok, Murygin, Goncharov. And the seeding committee knew what they were doing, putting young Grigory Murygin in the last three or four. And she's come through to claim a podium finish, I do believe. We've still got out there. Perez, Asiello, Yarovyi. We certainly don't need this rain softening the snow further with lots of races still to come. Last thing on the mind of Roman Petushkov, I venture to say. Maxim Yarovny, second in the 7.5K biathlon, hasn't had such a good day over the longer distance. She does enjoy the extra 5 kilometres. Umbrellas are everywhere. This is overall pretty grim news for the course. Enzo Masiello. Masiello just missed a couple of targets with his last shoot. 5 in all in this. 750 metres extra to ski, and that will knock around your time severely. Repeating for Roman Petushkov, has collected a third Paralympic Winter Games title. And teammates Bychenok and Murygin, and of course, is Goncharov. Kubo comes across 2:45 outside Petushkov's time, and he's in sixth position, the dogged Japanese competitor. Augusto Jose Perez. That last shoot from him, and that's taken him down the field. He missed 4 of his last 5 shots. Oh, that's what he's thinking about now.
Спасибо огромное, ребята, друзья, товарищи, приятели. Я вас всех люблю. Спасибо вам большое. Я думаю, что вам доставил радость большую. Это самое главное.
Upset Perez, unlike Petushkov. That's the difference between their fortunes today. The different emotions they must be feeling. The rain tumbling down, just messing with our snow. There's a lot going on here. The hearts and minds of our competitors. And under the umbrellas of our spectators. Maxim Yarovyi. He is the only competitor in the LW10 sport class. And that means he gets the most generous factoring applied to his time, with 86%. We should be expecting him in real time to finish towards the end. But in factored time will be significantly better than this. So it's going to be a few minutes off the pace of Petushkov, though. Hasn't had his best day. Yarovyi, and the reason is he missed a total of 6 targets. they've got everybody in. So that's good news. And I believe at the moment we've got everybody finished. It started. Results here for the Russian Federation. Check some results for you. The women's 10K, first of all, Anya Vicker of Germany, from Svetlana Konovalova of Russia, then Ukraine's Ludmila Pavlenko. There you're 1-2-3. Vitovska just missing out on the podium. Yodlova was disqualified. Eskow didn't finish. That women's event had some drama, it had some controversy, but it had a sweet story with Anya Vicker emerging victorious. And a different kind of sweet story here for the men's event. The Russian 1-2-3-4. Let's check the result for you in the men's 12.5K. Roman Petushkov, he just keeps on winning. Alexey Bychenok second, Grigory Murygin third, all for the Russian Federation, backed up by their teammate Ivan Goncharov in fourth position. Pleased to say all 19 starters completed the course. Run out of superlatives for Roman Petushkov. He's now assuming an aura of invincibility. He's 3 out of 3. He's on the cross-country 15K, the 7.5K biathlon, and now the 12.5K sitting biathlon. flower presentations for our first two events today, not far away, so I invite you to stay with us and enjoy those. They should be just minutes from now.
People from all of, I've ruined in Russia. People from Ukraine, from Russia. Please make some noise. gentlemen, flower ceremony for the biathlon women's 10 kilometers sitting.
Дамы и господа, цветочная церемония награждения победителей и призеров по биатлону. 10 километров. Женщины в классе сидя.
Well, the flower ceremony is ready now for the women's 10K sitting biathlon. And it's good to see the spectators have largely remained to observe what happens here. Victor's got some support in the crowd. You can hear the chant perhaps of Anya, Anya.
And she's
Svetlana Konovalova. And Ludmila Pavlenko. Deputy Mayor of Sochi here. They've got to be very proud of the job they've done for these games. And the ones in February. Ludmila Pavlenko, gold medalist in the 12K cross country, and now a bronze medal in the biathlon 10K. A little bit shy is our friend Ludmila Pavlenko. Putting together some great results is Svetlana Konovalova. Third in the 12K cross country, second in the 6K biathlon, now second in the 10K. I'm sure she'd swap perhaps two of those for one first placing, but she keeps the podium finishes coming, and surely the top spot isn't far away. Anya Vicker, the 22-year-old from Stuttgart. Sixth in the 6K biathlon, eighth in the cross country. But she brought her best performance to this race, no doubt about that. Absolutely outstanding in difficult conditions when others were missing. She was firing. And totally deserving Olympic Winter Games champion in the women's 4K. And gathering for more important photos. There's the result. Anya Vicker of Germany, Svetlana Konovalova of Russia, and Ludmila Pavlenko of Ukraine. First, second and third. The women's at 10K. Presentation for the men's 12.5K shouldn't be far away. Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, the flower ceremony for the biathlon men's 12.5 kilometers sitting.
Дамы и господа, цветочная церемония награждения победителей и призеров по биатлону. 12,5 километров. Мужчины в классе сидя.
One uniform, one nation, and two place getters. And Alexey Bychenok there, the last to go out. One of our three competitors from the Russian Federation, Roman Petushkov. Well, he's starting to look indomitable. Grigory Murygin. Looking forward to seeing more of this young man compete, and perhaps in wheelchair events as well, because he's taken a liking to the endurance events, wheelchair racing.
Yamabaki, governing board member of the International Paralympic Committee.
Visiting chair, господин Ясуши Ямаваки, член правления Международного паралимпийского комитета.
Bronze medalist representing Russian Federation.
Бронзовый призер, представитель Российской Федерации, Григорий Мурыгин.
Григорий Мурыгин. Just 19 years of age. He's got a big future ahead of him in Paralympic sport. Went to his first World Championships last year. A winner in the relay, second in the 10K sitting, and third in the 1K sprint. That was in cross country. And he finished 11th in the 12.5K biathlon. It hasn't improved on that here. Pick up his third place. Alexey Bychenok. Bychenok got fourth at the Worlds last year in Sweden in the 12.5K.
Hey, congratulations. You see the
arigato.
Inside Japan, it's tennis, discus, wheelchair racing. And for the last few years, biathlon and cross country.
Gold medalist and Paralympic champion, representing Russian Federation.
Золотую медаль и звание чемпиона Паралимпийских игр завоевал представитель Российской Федерации. Roman Petushkov!
Well, in Vancouver, Roman Petushkov had a silver medal in cross country and a bronze in biathlon. Here, Sochi, his three wins from three starts. And the 36. In his prime, one would suggest. Four gold medals at the 2013 World Championships in cross country.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Paralympic medalists!
So indeed, it's a Russian sweep of the medals in the men's 12.5K sitting biathlon. Roman Petushkov, Alexey Bychenok, and Grigory Murygin.
gentlemen, we're looking forward to the next competitions. The next competition will be...
Well, we've had difficult conditions, but we've had some brilliant racing, some exciting results. I hope you're continuing to enjoy what we have here from the Laura Cross Country and Biathlon Centre. More good races to come, though, so we hope you can join us for those. For the moment, it is goodbye from Laura.